he controlled himself. "We're in hell," he said to himself. The man doing the dishes started telling dirty jokes that caused lots of laughs to the people around him. Ethan wasn't laughing, making the guy think Ethan was a goody-goody. "What are you... what? 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 Are you so great? And I'm so stupid that you can't laugh at my jokes?" shouted the man angrily. "Your jokes are funny," shouted Newton. "Your jokes are funny," shouted Newton with depression. "No, you're just saying that so you won't make me hit you. You're really just afraid of me is all." And he savagely hit the board just depressed Newton in the face, sending Newton crashing down to the sudsy floor. Newton suddenly realized the punch the man delivered him had broken his nose. Newton went berserk and leaped onto the snickering man. He started tearing into the man. The man went screaming about the kitchen as Newton tore into him with fistic fury, causing him to be fired and put in jail for the night. In the prison, Newton painfully straightened out his nose and stared with despair at Sheena, who just looked helplessly at him from outside the bars. "Why, Newton? Why?" she asked. "You're right, Sheena. It really was a stupid idea to give up Mutania. Things were getting boring on the ship, but I never dreamed that planet life as a human being could be so utterly absurd and miserable. Yet, almost all our ancestors, well, my Earth ancestors, lived like this. Something tells me that I sent heaven into the sun to live in hell. This is hell. Human living is hell," shouted Newton with despair. "What are we going to do?" asked Sheena, trying to keep from crying. "I'd love to blow my brains out, but who knows? If my ancestors could live like this, and, well, your ancestors lived like this also, maybe we can too?" A week later, Newton and Sheena found someone that would give them enough money to live on for several months from one of the crystals they had on them. They also were able to buy a house with it. Days went by, and the two found themselves boredly watching the television. Television was a new thing on the planet. So new was it that it was in black and white. Since TV was new, it was exciting to the Sardonians, but excruciatingly boring for Newton and Sheena. Although television was new, the planet was fairly well advanced in other technologies like war. There were 8 greedy superpowers who had nuclear weapons. So powerful was one of the weapons that if it were detonated, it would totally incinerate the entire planet. The country Newton and Sheena were now living in was the most stable and practical planet. Its leader had a big military to keep the other 7 countries from invading it. But it was the country that was for peace and brotherhood. The president of Newton's country was called Jolot Panumo, who feared that it would just be a matter of time until his country was invaded, and that he'd have to use his military, or another country would be invaded, and that country would have to use its weapons to the extent of destroying the entire planet. So fearful was Numo becoming that he and a group of wealthy, concerned citizens got together to try to figure out a way to save their planet. Although religion was dying out on the planet due to new advances in science and technology, Numu got a crazy idea to make it look as though the savior of their planet was returning and would set up his kingdom on the planet. "How in the world can we pull off this lie?" asked one of the rich men. President Numu paced back and forth in his room, in the room of his palace, and said, "We'll use our media. Give them stories to report that will make like the holy writings are coming true. The HW reports earthquakes and disasters. Well, the HW reports earthquakes and disasters. We'll have the media report them. But people aren't going to believe that if they don't happen, shouted one of the scientists in despair. We'll detonate bombs under the surface of Sardana. The Holy Writings talk about a future battle between Hemlon and Grovatona. We must start drawing more attention to those two little countries. The more we can make it look like the Holy Writings are coming true, the more stability will occur in this planet. Our planet is becoming dangerous just because everyone is losing faith in the HW, shouted Numa with a look of desperation on his face. A rich man raised his hand and said, Mr. President, Hemlon is going to have to only have little skirmishes with Gravitona because it says in the HW that once Hemlon attacks and conquers Gravitona, the king of Hemlon shall be filled with devils who will rule the world for 7 years. They'd be destroyed by the coming of our savior. We may be able to make it look like prophecy is being fulfilled by reporting skirmishes between those two peaceful towns, but countries. But if we make Hemlon invade Grovatona, people will start reading the HW and expect the savior in 7 years. Earthquakes and hard times would be easy to do, but do you think our technology will be able to be advanced enough in the future to make a man do miracles like God? Hey, said the president, whoever thought that we would have the splitting of atoms or man out in orbit? 5 years ago, if you told someone that we would be going to have people on TV, they would have thought you were insane. Or describing something of a prophetic miracle come true. Why, at the rate our technology is increasing, it will be just a matter of time until we have heaven on earth, laughed the president. President Nemo then became excited and shouted, as we plan out all these disasters, if Hemlon should attack and conquer Grovatona, let's find a cure for the old age. People are only religious because they hope that when they die, they'll be young again in heaven. Yes, but one of the miracles that people hope to expect from the Savior is being rejuvenated, shouted an old rich woman. Numa paused for a moment and said, I used to be a scholar of the Holy Writings. I was vain and hopeful for heaven too, in that respect, but I never found passages in it that talked about people being rejuvenated back to their youth, only in heaven. I think having our man-made savior passing out anti-aging drugs in the form of communion wafers will satisfy that problem well enough. And as the president and his men went on planning a way to try to save their planet, Newton was slaving away as a janitor at a school for children with mental problems. Newton came home all stinky and dirty and found Sheena looking at the TV that showed excruciatingly stupid cartoons. The sound was off, though, yet Sheena looked really depressed for some reason. What's the matter? Asked Newton. Sheena started crying. Oh no, shouted Newton. Yes, she said. I'm pregnant. Newton turned off the television and sat down. Man, when kids arrive, it's always at times when you don't want them, isn't it? Asked Newton. The days of fun are over, said Sheena. Are over? Asked Newton. When did they begin? We haven't even had our honeymoon yet, laughed Newton. Newton then found himself pacing about the room. Well, if I could take care of Bruno for 60 years, why not a kid? Bruno was just a big baby, a violent, powerful baby, a dangerous and monstrous baby. I think we will be able to afford an extra mouth to feed, we just won't be able to live in luxury is all. Nathan sat down with a look of anxiety on his face. How come I feel so claustrophobic? I haven't felt like this since I was trapped with Obakoba on that planet with floating cities. She covered her face and with her hand and asked, was the planet's girth as dismally boring as this place? Sheena, you and I, the crew, found... Sheena, you and I and the crew found excitement on Girth. But here, Sardana is the pits. Newsom said as he watched the cars go by on the highway next to his home. This next story I'm about to read is called Triplets of Newton. Newton stood at the edge of a river by a bridge as a gentle rain washed down on him. Out in the distance, Newton looked at some high-rises of a city that he was seriously thinking of running away to. But now that Sheena was due to have a child any day now, Newton felt trapped. But he was still very fond of her, no matter how miserable and depressed they were. Newton was suddenly caught in a downpour of rain. He suddenly realized that his miserable existence was just a result of being born on Mutania. Instead of crying, though, he suddenly found himself laughing. He just laughed and laughed. When the image of Mutania perishing in the heat of the star he sent it into, went through his mind, he suddenly splashed down up into the river and began floating down it, laughing constantly as it kept on raining on him. When he got home, Sheena was startled to see him so wet. It frightened her so much that it caused her to go into labor. Being the type of alien humanoid she was, and a day later, she gave birth to three children. Having three children at once was common for the type of person she was, but she was vainly hoping that with Newton's new body, it would be a different thing. 5 days later, Newton and Sheena were trying to take care of the three bawling kids. To keep his mind off of his predicaments, Newton turned on the boring black and white and saw a kiddie show with a clown on it. Newton grabbed his hair and almost screamed. He then ran for the door and was just about to open it when suddenly... Sheena yelled, "Please don't leave me!" Newton turned and saw her with a baby in her arms that looked something like a Martian. Newton then found himself laughing again. I have to go out and get a breath of fresh air. He laughed with a deranged look in his on his face. A month later, Newton managed to sell another crystal and got so much money for it that he and Sheena were able to have servants to take care of their three kids. They now had so much money that they could buy a car. Newton's next-door neighbor skinned up his leg and broken. Newton's next-door neighbor skinned up his leg and broke his arm on his motorcycle and was going to throw his motorcycle into the river, but Newton said, "Hey, why don't you give it to me?" And Newton found himself on the motorcycle. Something he wasn't really familiar with. An early clone of me had one, he said to his neighbor. Clone? Or did you say clown? Asked the man. He suddenly realized that he was no longer living in a cloned body of the old Matt Mason series, but was now living in the Branko body clone series. I don't know what I was saying, said Newton, and he started the motorcycle up. A few minutes later, Newsom found himself going down back alleyways, riding down old abandoned orchard roads, and on his new motorcycle. When he felt he had it really under control, Newsom got it on the road and made the cycle go as fast as it could go. It was overcast and starting to get late. Newsom realized that he should be getting back, but he didn't want to get back. There was a large stretch of road out in front of him that led to a mountainside. Newsom suddenly began thinking about the past, about Mutania and his crew before he met the Black Mutants in the 20th century. He began to think about the great exciting adventures he used to have and how Mutania's powerful warp engines began to hum loudly as it took he and his crew away from danger. As Newton thought about the way it was, the more depressed he felt himself getting, and the angrier he became with himself for letting the hormones of his new body affect his love for Mutania and Sheena. Newton suddenly felt tears of despair running down his cheeks. Oh, how he missed Mutania. Newton angrily gunned the gas on his cycle, causing the speedometer to quickly go up on the dial. The speedometer was reading 60 before he gunned it. It now read 80 miles per hour and climbing. Newton felt the bike vibrating in his hands now. The loud engine became louder and louder, making Newton imagine that it was the engines of Mutania. I'm not a man of the ground. I'm a man of space, shouted Newton. Warp 100, he screamed, and he squeezed the gas with his might, making the motorcycle speedometer read 100 miles per hour and accelerating. Newton then began trying to imagine that the fruit trees in the orchard he was passing by were stars. The bike went faster and faster, cars and trucks that quickly shot past him. Newton tried to imagine his galaxies. Newton then felt himself going crazy. He started laughing. He looked into the distance at the foot of a hill and saw a large boulder 10 feet from the side of the road. I'll disappear into another dimension. That one last dimension I have never seen. Newton then got all of his attention on the big gray boulder that was zooming quickly to him. He would slam into it at 150 miles per hour in 10 seconds. Newton then began to the countdown, imagining himself on the bridge of Mutania with his crew that used to be alive. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. But right when Newton was 1 second from slamming into the massive boulder, Sheena's crying, sad face appeared into his mind, causing him to shout, "No!" He quickly slammed on his brakes and threw his weight to the side. Newton just missed the boulder, but the back wheel ticked the side of it, causing Newton to lose control of his motorcycle. Newton suddenly found his panicking hands grappling quickly for the handlebars, but it was impossible because the bike was now hitting little rocks that kept him from getting it totally under control. Newton and his motorcycle quickly shot up the grass-covered hill, hit a ditch, and sent Newton into the face of a mountain with the motorcycle crashing to the side of him. When Newton came to, it was dark and raining on his face that was covered with mud and wet grass. Newton felt sore all over. He also realized that his nose was broken again. He was going to hitch a ride back to his town, but when no one would pick him up, he fixed up his motorcycle and, to his amazement, discovered that it could take him back home. And he did go back home. At home, he found his, At home, he found his tired, frustrated wife sleeping soundly in front of the TV. When Newton realized that there wasn't, that there weren't any bawling babies, he thanked the creator of the universe. As the months went by, Newton and Sheena's nerves were frazzled from the three children. But somehow, they were able to carry on like regular humans living in time. Newton's nose was healed from the bike crash, and he managed to keep his job as a janitor at the school for mentally deficient children. Newton hated his job, but the smell of washing floors and toilets was better than the smell poor Sheena was putting up with at home. At night, when school was out and he was all done with the cleaning, he would come home and sit with a tired... and sit with a tired, vegetating look on his face as the black and white television flashed scenes of boring shows. Newton was tired. Sheena would dance around naked in front of him, but he was afraid he'd end up with six kids if he indulged himself, so he just petted and played with her. Birth control hadn't been invented yet. It hadn't been invented on the planet, on planet Sardana yet. When the news came on, the president of the country Newton and Sheena were in said that he was going to try to get the scientists to contact the aliens that had visited Sardana several years ago in the effort to try to help Sardana settle its problems. Newton wondered who the aliens were that President Pneuma was talking about. One of the scientists later came onto the news and suddenly shocked and frightened Newton when he said, "We should not try to contact any aliens because we might get in contact with the evil demon that attacked and terrified our planet some 50 years ago." When the scientist whispered the name Newton, Newton's eyes bulged. "Did I attack this planet?" he asked Sheena. She didn't think so. "I didn't attack it. This is strange that they would say that I did." Newton was surprised that he had never heard the name Newton on Sardana until now. It was like some big secret or something. He was also surprised that they kept space aliens. Newton was also surprised that they kept space aliens out of common conversation. He was also surprised that they kept space aliens out of common conversation also if he did in fact attack Sardana before. Newton then called up a friend and asked, "Did a space alien named Newton attack Sardana around 40 years ago? Nalab?" Newton's friend Nalab asked, "What? Is this a joke? So it didn't happen then, right?" asked Newton again. "How come you don't know about Newton?" asked Nalab. "Are you an alien?" The concern in Nalab's voice made Newton think that it was wrong to be an alien. "No, it's just strange that people believe in aliens is all, don't you think?" Neela paused and said, "Sardana has been visited from other planets for centuries," thought Newton. You're an alien, aren't you?" asked Neela again. Newton paused for a while and said, "Well, if you want to know the truth, I'm not a native of Sardana." Neela then became excited and asked, "Really? What planet are you from? Have you ever heard of Earth?" "Yes, I have. The people who were last on Sardana were from Earth. Well, at least that's what our government... I'm gonna have to get to the... Have you ever heard of Earth? Yes, I have. The people who were last on Sardana were from Earth. Well, at least that's what our government... leaked out. The last spacey thing that ever made history, though, was that... The last thing that ever made history, though, was that horrible Newton. That horrible Newton thing that attacked us. It was one of the most terrifying things to occur in our history. No one talks about it, though, from the fear that Newton could be down here. Newton threatened us, saying that if he heard anyone saying anything bad about him, he'd destroy one of our cities. Newton asked Neela to go on about this monster who terrified Sardana. Neela went on and said that Newton would hide among them, and if he heard them saying something evil about Newton, he would cause great harm. And he did. Oh, yeah. Neela went on and said that Newton would hide among them, and if he heard them say something evil about Newtonia, he would cause great harm, and he did. Newtonia, shocked Newton. That's right, Branko, Newtonia. When Newton finally quit talking with his friend, he suddenly realized the great... Yeah. When Newton finally quit talking with his friend, he suddenly realized the great silence. Oh. Excuse me. Newtonia... asked shocked Newton. That's right, Branko, Newtonia. When Newton finally quit talking with his friend, he suddenly realized the great silence. Man, it's a good thing I am now now possessing a body that doesn't look like my original Sheena. It's just bizarre, though. I'm sure I didn't attack or threaten this planet. Could it have been the Black Mutant, Newton? Asked an excited Sheena. I don't know. He knew Mutania was Mutania. Unless he decided to experiment by calling Black Teen Newtonia when he attacks Sardana. Oh well, it's just another one of those puzzles again. A few weeks later, it was night time. The triplets were bawling and really driving Newton and Sheena batty. Things were getting so out of hand that Newton almost hit little Matthew with his fist, but he gritted his teeth and punched a wall instead. Little Jeff Newton was hitting Shirley on the head with a plastic phone. Newton yelled, "Stop this," but they didn't mind and continued to do what they were.